The Clever Courtier. Akbar is one of the greatest kings of all time. Besides being a fearless warrior, he was also a man of intelligence and vision. If Akbar possessed a flaw, it was his vanity. Akbar was tolerant towards all religions. One day, after listening to a discussion on the Ramayana, and the Empanna declared that he was a reincarnation of Lord Rama. The Hindu pundits were horrified. Akbar was a great king, but how could a merry mortal and a Muslim at the claim be an incarnation of Lord Rama? The emperor's false notion had to be rebuffed. After the question was how, Mahesh Das was a young Brahmin with a sharp wit. He heard of the pundit's dilemma. "Take me with you to the Darbar tomorrow," he pleaded. "Perhaps I can convince Shahrishah Akbar that he is not a Bahavan Rama." The pundits scoffed at the idea, but Mahesh Das was adamant. "Who is the young lad?" the emperor asked the pundits, and Mahesh Das bowed before him in the court the following day. "How is such a young boy, who is not hair on his chin, in the company of learned men like you? If Shah Alam judges the man wisdom by the number of hairs on his chin, I can produce he one is the wiser than us all," said Mahesh Das. Mahesh Das left the court and reappeared a few minutes later, leading a billy goat with a long beard. The pundits shot anxious glances towards Akbar. Would he be angry at Mahesh Das's impertinence? But Akbar smiled. "You are a small boy, but your wits are sharp," he said. If his majesty would prefer someone large, I can bring in a camel or an elephant," said Mahesh Das. The pundits gasped. Surely this time Mahesh Das had gone too far, but the emperor burst off laughing. "Be careful, my boy," he said. "The sharp tongue can get you into trouble." Akbar pointed the jug full of water and the pile of stones that Mahesh Das had with him. "What are these for?" he asked. Mahesh Das approached the throne. "Jahapana, I would you like to get a humble request? Please throw these stones in the jug of water so they can land in one top of each other." The emperor looked at the very young Brahmin with a confused expression on his face. Then he took the jug and the stones from him and proceeded to throw the stones into the water. Out of the lot, only two stones landed on top of each other. The rest lay scattered about. "That was more difficult than I thought," Akbar commented. "Halappana, Lord Rama had a bridge built across the ocean from India to Lanka in a similar manner," said Mahesh Das. "So you are trying to prove that Lord Rama was far greater than you, your emperor." Akbar's voice was tinged with both annoyance and admiration. He turned to the pundits. "This young lad is a far better pundit than all of you. We will make him a courtier. I enjoy the company of the clever minds." Then, looking at Mahesh Das, Akbar said, "My young friend, that what you have to say." Mahesh Das could not believe his good fortune. He bowed and said, "Jahapana, I will serve you with my heart and soul." Mahesh Das soon came to be known as Birbal. And this is how he met Emperor Akbar for the first time. This is the end of the story named as The Clever Courtier. The Clever